My colleagues are actually using V6 without noticing it. When we started, there was no V6 in Europe, or hardly any. So we had a tunnel to UUnet in the UK, and that was it. These days, about every exchange point in the world is V6 capable. If you look at the DE kicks in Frankfurt, for example, about one third of the ISPs has V6 now. In about every country in Europe, there will be ISPs, smaller ISPs that do V6 today. So there's local expertise. Go to your peers, ask them about V6, ask them what sort of product they use, what experience they had, and maybe pay them for some consulting. But there's local expertise, and you just need to share with your colleagues. There's some big advantages in V6, and that's the whole subnet size calculation. In V4, experience shows that whatever size you pick for a subnet, it's either too small or too big. In V6, you just put a 64 on it, and that will be enough forever. And this really saves on address space management, address space planning, network planning, and all the overhead that everybody takes for granted, but really shouldn't be necessary. If you ever tell that to a customer, "I'm not giving you what you're asking for," the customer will be unhappy, and that's a bad way to start a business relation. In V6, the customer asks for a block, and you give him a block, and the block will be bigger than whatever he needs. One of the arguments that is made by people that think we are doing it all wrong with V6 is you have not learned from the past, and you're giving out big chunks of addresses again, and so we are doing the same mistakes, and V6 will run out. What these people just don't do is do the proper math behind it. What we are currently giving to providers is 32s. We have 4 billion of 32s. There's no way there will ever be 4 billion ISPs in the world. V4 is good enough. As long as people can get to whatever they want, like get to Google, get to YouTube with V4, they have no pressing need to go to V6. They will start caring about technology if V4 breaks for them. And basically that's too late. So the providers should be ready before that and before V4 actually runs out. I would be happy if you could rid of this legacy IP stuff, IPv4. It's just a legacy from the last century. And it's not like V6 is solving world hunger and anything, but it's solving a very critical problem in V4, and that's the address space. And given that the address space is so tight, V4 brings up other problems.